It's time for your daily crypto update with Framework Fortune Crypto. I'm your host, Ben. Now let's dive in. So Bitcoin, boy, did it look bleak there yesterday. It's looking very close to a crack, but seeing a nice bounce today off of that 30,000. We'd cracked it some and was able to hold up still, even though it's cracked below it. Buyers came in and pushed this back up all the way to the top of that sloping channel. Now we're not out of the woodworks yet. This could easily be a rejection, as it looks like right now, and come back down and still crack. So don't get too excited yet seeing this nice big rebound on Bitcoin. And this was about a $3,000 rebound. So it's been a while since we've had some nice moves, a couple weeks here, and finally getting a little bit of upward movement. Now, if Bitcoin can close strong today and then open up tomorrow right around the top and then break through the top, well, that 35,000 area is right here. And I would say if we break through that 35,000 area, this is not going to be the long bear market that people were talking about, which is what I'm expecting, is this sell-off to be almost done with. But at the moment, we're still in indecision, still in consolidation. So we don't know for sure what way we are going to go. But it was nice to see a rebound across the crypto market. Ethereum, same thing. Bounced off that bottom support at that 1750, 1720. That actually held up, showing that that is some good support there. Breaking over the downtrend today and also breaking back over 2000 momentarily. So Ethereum is very close to being out of this downtrend of sell-off, which means that Ethereum could start going back bullish very soon if we continue to see buying come in over the next couple of days. Cardano bouncing strong off of that dollar support, confirming that dollar is going to be very strong support no matter what happens, and that is a good sign. But confirmed it multiple times up to the downtrend, same thing as Ethereum. Cardano's close to maybe breaking back out and moving up. But holding that dollar support shows very good strength on Cardano. Now today's top gainer, we got Matic. Matic with a break out of this triangle here, you can see there. So Matic may start going back bullish. It's still got to get above some EMAs. That needs to get above that area of 125 that's held up as pretty strong resistance over the last couple of weeks. Now, one of their stable coins was hacked, but it wasn't the Polygon network itself. So maybe that stable coin getting hacked won't affect it as much as I thought it was going to. We did have a straight down sell-off there for about a week after more people caught word of that hacking. But people coming back in and buying it today, so good sign there. Since we're seeing a little bit of a rebound, ICP is one to keep on watch for a possible day trade, maybe swing trade. Pretty low, all the way down here at 30. Last time it started bouncing off a $30 area, it ran all the way up to 60. So I would expect, if we continue to see a rebound, this have another big run like that at some point, some type of pop up this week or over the weekend. Shiba, I haven't covered in a while because it cracked the uptrend here and it's been selling off, but we did get a little bounce. It won't be bullish again until it can get back above the uptrend. So nothing really on Shiba at the moment. Dash the other day we saw with a big pop, had a little bit of a pullback yesterday, but pushing up again today. Volume is coming in to Dash, so this could be one to watch the rest of the week, as it does look like we may get an engulfing bull candle right here. If this body of this green candle closes above the red one today, which could lead to more buying coming in and a push up. We could possibly see Dash back up to 160 if it can break the 50 day, and then maybe 180. So another one to keep on watch. Atom still got buyers in this area, in that $10 area. It is back above 10 now. So we'll see if that climb can continue. But if it's anything like Cardano showing that strength at a dollar, it's looking like we're showing pretty good strength at the $10 area for Atom. So Does have a ways to go to get back moving in the upward direction. Got to get over 15, but not bad today. So Polkadot, I was saying that this area is probably a good area around this $10-$11 to grab some if you're interested in getting that interest for holding it on Voyager. If it continues to climb, it's going to run a resistance at 15, but then break of 15, it could easily get back up in this 20 to 25 area. So this is kind of what I'm expecting to see if we continue to rebound, is all these cryptos get back up to these previous areas of consolidation and consolidate on those levels again for a little while before we have a big breakout. But this could be a short-lived rebound today because we are still very bearish on all these cryptos. Now, XLM may be one to keep an eye on. Had this little indecision candle yesterday and then turning green today following the indecision. And it looks like it may try to break over this 25 cent area of this previous level. If it can do that, LXM might try to get back up to 30 here soon, which would be pretty strong resistance because it was strong support back here. But nice little indecision candle there with this little reversal starting on XLM. So that's all the coins I'm going to cover for today. We're still in indecision and consolidation. We've been consolidating downwards on a lot of these. So we need confirmation of a trend reversal. This bounce today on all these coins is not enough. Things could still get sketchy. So be very cautious when thinking about your trades or building a position. And we do have strong support that has held up, so we could see that trend reversal. It is not out of the realm of possibilities. If there's any coins that I'm not currently covering on a weekly basis that you would like me to cover, leave it down in the comments below and let me know your thoughts on the coins that I am covering. Appreciate everybody joining me as always. If you haven't yet checked out frameworkfortune.com, stay safe out there. Until next time.